Now let's take a look at how material flows through an enrichment plant. Material enters the enrichment plant in the form of uranium hexafluoride. Commercial uranium enrichment facilities typically receive the uranium hexafluoride in large drums that can hold up to 12,500 kilograms. This UF6 is transported from the conversion plant to the enrichment plant via truck or rail. When it arrives at the plant, the material is weighed. Then, depending upon the facility, this material may undergo non-destructive assay analysis or statistical sampling to verify the purity and isotopic concentration. The material is then put into a storage queue awaiting processing. If we look at a simplified uranium enrichment plant diagram, we see that the material is received here. In general, safeguards for uranium enrichment facilities are based around two broad material balance areas. The first material balance area covers shipping, receiving, and any storage areas. The second material balance area covers the process areas, which includes the cascade halls. Since we are weighing and possibly analyzing the concentration of the material at the point at which it is received, we will place a key measurement point, or KMP, at this point, before it enters the storage area. The UF6, as it is stored, is in a solid crystalline form. This form is easy to handle and weigh. After it enters the feed input area, it will generally be heated to a gas state and be fed into the cascades. The process for this will depend on the type of enrichment plant, but the end result is a gas product being fed into the cascade hall. There will also be some small amount of waste as a result of this process, so we need to monitor the material entering the cascade halls to have an accurate measurement of the UF6 gas that enters the enrichment area. This could be accomplished using an online flow monitor, for instance. As it undergoes the enrichment process, there is a constant withdrawal of both product and tails from the cascades, and those streams are then cooled back down to a solid state and transferred into storage. There is another key measurement point here, at the point where both of these streams are weighed and sampled once again before being moved into storage. In the case of the tails, this material is generally put into long-term storage at the facility. The product is put into short-term storage and then possibly blended and homogenized in the weighing and sampling area before ultimately being shipped to a customer, which is generally the fuel fabrication facility. As we can see here, we place key measurement points at basically every point where the material stream enters or exits one of the two main material balance areas. Thank you.